Hello everyone and welcome back to the Cyclocross Social Podcast. Today we're taking a look ahead at the World Cup in Val d'Isère, which is a special one because it's taking place on snow, it's in the Alps, and it's here in an attempt to get the sport on the Winter Olympics in the future. And I'm taking a look at this with two special guests. In the first part of the podcast I will speak with Eva Lechner, in the second part I will speak with Alice Marie Arzufi, the Italian champion, and finally I will speak with Twan a bit about our thoughts on it, but obviously the thoughts of Lechner and Arzufi are way more interesting. As said, in the first part of the podcast I was speaking with Eva Lechner. She's an 11-time Italian champion cyclocross. She is also the winner of the silver medal at last year's World Championships mountain bike, and she also has a silver medal at the World Championships cyclocross. Eva, welcome on our podcast.
Hello, everybody.
Could you shortly introduce yourself to our listeners?
I'm Eva Lechner. I'm from Italy, and I'm living in South Tyrol. That's pretty close by Val d'Isère World Cup. It's about 50-60k from my house. And I'm a cyclist since 20 years now. I started with mountain biking and did also some road riding. And 2009, I started with cyclocross. And since then, I did every winter some cyclocross races. And my love for cyclocross was growing year by year. And I'm still here. And this season, I'm riding for the Fast Airport Services team. It's a new Italian team just for cyclocross, and we are four Italian girls, with Alicia Maria Zuffi, Silvia Persico, Lucia Bramati, and myself. And it's really exciting, and I really like cyclocross.
We'll ask you a couple of short questions. As you said, you've been racing for a long time. In all those years, what is your favorite parkour you've ever done?
One of my favorites is the World Cup in Namur, the course in Namur.
Yeah, we hear that one a lot from cyclists. There you will probably be looking for a bit of a tougher tire thread. But what is your favorite tire thread out of all of the options you have?
As I like mud, I like the mud tire.
Outside of cyclocross, what is your favorite winter sport?
I haven't done it that often in the past because I'm racing cyclocross, but I like cross country skiing.
And when you're not racing yourself and you have a bit of rest, what is your favorite Netflix show to watch?
Actually, I watched a lot of shows on Netflix, and I'm just choosing the newest shows and going on. I'm asking always my friends what's the best show now to watch, and so I'm going on.
And what is your favorite food to eat?
As an Italian, I love pizza, but I really like also sushi.
And then a final question: who is your favorite cyclist of all time?
Yeah, for Italy, of course, for cyclocross, I like my coach Luca Bramati and our national coach Daniele Pontoni, of course, as an Italian. And for the woman, I got always inspired by Paola Pezzo, as she's also Italian. And international, I like for road riding riders like Julian Alaphilippe or Peter Sagan, and many others.
And now to the World Cup in Val d'Isère. It's a race in your own country. Can you tell us what makes it special to race in your own country?
Yeah, because it's really special because it's close by my house, and my family and my friends can come to watch, and are close by, and there are a lot of Italian fans. So it's just some extra motivation for me to give my best, and that's why I'm really looking forward to it.
The race will be held in the snow. Do you like racing in the snow?
Yes, actually, I did it a few times already. I think Val d'Isère is a little bit special because the snow is really made, and I think the course is also prepared to be totally on the snow. So it will be a little bit different. But basically, riding on the snow is technical difficult, and normally I like it a lot if it's technical and difficult, and so that's why I think I will like it.
And about your opponents, who do you think benefits of racing in the snow?
I think just riders, they are technical strong riders, can benefit of it. And riders, they're not afraid and maybe just have a good control of the bike.
So then we're maybe looking at Puk Pieterse and Celine Del Carmen Alvarado, who have a good technique.
Yes, for sure, yeah. The young riders.
And is riding through loose snow kind of comparable with riding through sand, or is it completely different?
Yes, some of the riders, they compare it and they say it's quite similar, and it is also something similar, but on the other side, it is a little bit, yeah, it's similar, but on the same side, also different. Difficult to understand, to describe.
Is the difference maybe that in sand it's more about the bike control, whilst in the snow you still need to put down a lot of power because the snow slows you more than sand?
Yeah, that's probably like this, yes. And then it depends how the snow is, if it's really wet or dry, and yeah, but that's with the sand, it's the same. It also changes a little bit for their different kind of sands.
In your career, you've without a doubt had a couple of races in the snow. Are there any that stand out to you that you have memories from?
Yeah, I remember, I don't know which year it was, but it was Carlmount, I think 2010 or something like, or 2009 or 2010, one of the first years. It was snowing really, really a lot. It was, I don't know how many centimeters, but it was totally in winter wonderland. And that was crazy. And it was snowing during the race.
And how did that race go for you? Did you like it or?
I liked it, but that was one of my first races I did. And so I had to start a lot in the back. And it was really small, the track. So I couldn't pass, and I just was blocked a little bit by other riders, but I had a lot of fun.
Well, you've obviously already raced on the mountain bike in Val di Sole. Could you tell us a bit about the location where the World Cup is going to be hosted?
Yeah, I raced a couple of times already in Val di Sole. Actually, I did already two World Championships there and many World Cups. And yeah, it's always special, and I really like Val di Sole, and it was always well organized race, and the organizers put a lot of effort to put a big show. And also last year at the World Championship, it was so cool, so many people out there to cheering for the riders, and it was really a great event. So that's why I'm sure also Val di Sole Cyclocross World Cup will be nice event.
Do you think there will be many fans going to Val di Sole to support the riders and potentially all the Italians?
I hope so.
We also hope so, but how do you think that the popularity of cyclocross in Italy is at the moment? From a long time ago, we remember cyclocross was really popular in Italy. Recently, it's been very difficult to organize races in Italy. So how popular is the sport still in Italy?
Yeah, it was a little struggling in the past years. I have the feeling it got a little bit better now in the past years. But yeah, comparing to how it was one time when like my coach Luca was racing in Italy, it changed a lot. And yeah, I hope it goes back to that times where the cyclocross was what it was one time.
And what do you think is needed for that? Is a World Cup in Italy essential for that time to come back?
Yeah, maybe. I mean, for sure, it's a good thing to have a World Cup in Italy, and it's forcing to come fans out to watch and bring big stars to watch. I think, yeah, if riders like Matthew or Wout or even Pidcock are coming, I'm sure that a lot of people are coming and getting excited for cyclocross.
Do you think that this big World Cup will play a role in that?
Of course, if there are big races, maybe also young riders are getting interested and interested to start, and looking up to it, for sure it can help.
about young riders in Italy. How is it if you are a young cyclocross rider in Italy? Do you know that? Because here in the Netherlands and Belgium, if you're a young rider, you can ride a race every weekend, pretty close to your house, only a 1 hour drive. How is that in Italy?
Yeah, I started racing when I was already elite, so I don't have that. I didn't have that chance, but I see that there are many races every weekend. Even last season, when all the COVID was going on, there was just Italian, just in Belgium racing going on. But in Italy, you could race every weekend. There was a race going on for the young riders, and that was really exciting to see. And yeah, so they still had a season going on, and it's the same also this year. And that's great to see.
And is there any young talent coming through in Italy? Maybe a name you've seen who you think we should keep an eye on out for the rest of the season or the future seasons, I must say?
Yeah, I mean, there are some young riders. We had in the junior, for example, we had, she was third in Tabor.
Frederica Venturelli.
Frederica, yeah. And yeah, she's first year junior, and there are still some younger riders coming up. And yeah, one is also my teammate, Lucia, sister daughter of Luca. She's already under 23. And Lucia Bramati. There are some other juniors and younger riders, yeah, that they still have to grow. So it's difficult to say who is really getting strong.
This year we also saw your teammate Silvia Persico do very good. It was kind of a breakout performance she had. Do you think that she can also develop into a consistent top 10 rider?
Yes, of course. She's a really good rider, and she's one of the riders that's not afraid. So I'm pretty sure she's doing also good. She will also do a good great race in Val di Sole if she has a good day. She's really convinced, and she got really strong this season, and now she's getting also her self-confidence about it. And it's exciting to see, because she's also a young rider, and she grew a lot. And yeah, I'm happy that I could see that she performed really well this season.
And what type of rider is she? We don't know a lot about her. What are her strong points? You already said she has a lot of confidence, but does she excel on tougher courses or on faster courses or on sand? Or, well, you already mentioned snow, but what is she really good at?
She's better on the fast courses. I mean, she likes it more because she's a road rider, so she's really good tactical. And I don't know if you remember Bugense. She was under 23. She got fourth in the sprint. She did a really exciting race already there. But she's good also on the hard courses. Maybe she just don't like it, but we saw her racing really well in Over the Ice, and that's a really tough course. So I think she's good also on that courses, but she just is not convinced about herself that she's good on that too. But yeah, basically she's more for the faster courses, and yeah, she's also a good starter. So yeah, that helps a lot in cyclocross, I guess.
And do you think that your team also has a big role in the development of this talent? Because now there is a big women's team, almost all the big or top class women of Italy ride in this team. And do you guys make each other stronger on training? And does it help that you now have like a good team that can get you to all the World Cup races every week?
Yes, I'm pretty sure that it helps a lot. And we have really good times in the team. We are really like a team. We are always on one camper before the race, and we help each other. We are talking about the course, about tires, about lines, and everybody's just helping each other. And I think that's really important for the performance for every single rider. And so that's for sure important. And yeah, I'm really excited that we made this team and we can work together.
And do you also train together, or is that not possible?
We train together just on the races before, and watching the course. And if not, everybody's just at his house and training her program. But yeah, on the races we train together and we do.
And do you like being able to share your experiences with the younger riders to help them?
Yes, I'm more experienced and I'm happy to see young riders coming up, and I'm happy to help to grow them and to grow Italy, especially to have more big riders also for the future. And so that's something I really like it, and I'm excited to do it.
And then potentially, once you end your career, would you then also be interested in perhaps becoming like a coach for a team or a national team to share even more experience?
Yes, of course. That's one of my dreams.
If we then talk a bit more about the talent development, what do you think is needed for a big talent to arise in Italy? Is it perhaps the new World Cup? Will that benefit? Or does the sport need to become Olympic or something else?
I mean, the World Cup is for maybe important, but maybe also just more international races, and also more international participation. Because in Italy, you know, at the moment, also in international races, they are just Italian riders racing, and there's no international competition. And I think to grow, you need also more international competition. And yeah, of course, if you have the World Cup in Italy, or even more World Cups in Italy, and if there would be also the young categories on it, it would be easier for sure. So they can do that. But for sure, you need international high level competition to grow.
Internationalization is definitely needed, in my opinion, and Flanders Classics is saying that the World Cup is the first step to that. What is your thought on it? Of course, the extension of the World Cup has been a hot topic this year and also last year. But what do you think? 16 races are too many, too little, too many countries, not enough countries? What do you think about it?
I mean, it's quite a lot. On one side, we are also before it was like, if I race in Belgium or Netherlands, it was always like a World Cup participation. So it doesn't change that much from the participation. It's just that it's called World Cup. But yeah, I'm excited to do that many races, and also excited to have it in different nations, and not just Belgium and Holland, to go us to different places. It's exciting too.
I definitely think that's important. Val di Sole is a new addition to the calendar. You have raced 5 World Cups before in Italy on 4 different locations. Fiuggi was the last one. Do you think that the Val di Sole World Cup can be one that can stay? Because we've seen a lot of World Cups in Italy come and go because of the tough financial picture.
I'm pretty sure that Val di Sole is one of the races that can stay. It has different organizers, and we saw they organize also the World Cup in mountain biking, and they know what they do, and that's just, they are more experienced about organizing World Cup races, and that's why I think it can be also there in the future.
And for the race this year, what are your goals for that race?
To do my best. For sure, I would like to be in top 10, and if I can be also more in front, would be really nice, especially before in front of a home crowd and family and friends.
This year you got a top 10 in the World Cup of Iowa, and then you're hoping to get your second top 10 already in Kokside. 11th, you were pretty close, so I hope you can make it into the top 10. But of course the level is very high. Do you think that the level of women's cyclocross has gone up a lot over the past couple of years?
Yes, I'm pretty sure about it.
And what is that down to? Is it the improvement of the technique, or is it just the benefit of having youth categories, or is it the overall condition has become stronger?
I just think, yeah, overall, but you can see that a lot of young riders are coming up, and probably they are just training also a little bit different and stronger, and they also trained a lot on the technique, because I saw you see that young riders, they're really on a big level already in a technique, and in the past, when you were a really strong technical rider, you could benefit a lot. And now a lot of riders are on a bigger level. And I think they're improved in the technique, but also on the performance. Maybe the techniques of the training, they got better, and so just the performance growth, and it changed a lot. Yeah.
Well, we hope you can make it into the top 10 this weekend in Val di Sole. Thank you for wanting to talk about us with us about the World Cup and cyclocross in Italy.
Thank you. Thank you for the interview.
Well, that concludes our talk with Eva Lechner. Now we will be speaking with her teammate, Alice Marie Arzufi, the current Italian champion. And I'm sure she has some interesting things to say on the World Cup in Val di Sole as well. Alice, welcome on our podcast.
Hello, everybody. Hello to our listener. I'm happy to be here and talk in this podcast.
Could you maybe shortly introduce yourself?
Yes, I am Alice Marie Arzufi. I am 27 years old and I ride for FAS Airport Services, and I am the current Italian national champion.
We will be asking you a couple of short questions. The first one is, what is your favorite song to listen to when you are warming up for a race?
I actually don't have a favorite song, but I have a playlist. I usually listen to Dance Room on Spotify. You can find it easily. That is my favorite playlist.
And what is the favorite parkour you have ever raced on?
I really like the hilly parkours, and my favorite, I think, is Tabor. And then I really like also like Gavere, all the parkours with the climb, actually.
A lot of the races are in Belgium. What is the favorite thing about Belgium?
I really like the chocolate and the fries, actually, because it's something that you don't find so easy in Italy, and I really appreciate that.
And when you don't go to Belgium, what is your favorite place to go to when you have a holiday?
I think to have a relaxed holiday, I really like Sardinia in Italy, on the beach. But I also really like to visit the city. For example, my next trip, I think it will be in America again. To visit whether New York or Miami or Los Angeles, something like that. I really would like to do it.
And what is your favorite food?
Pizza, of course. I'm Italian.
Are you allowed to put pineapple on your pizza?
No, of course I'm not. No. I even can't hear that because it's something that is totally not Italian. No.
Well, a final question here for the short questions is, what is your favorite Netflix series or TV series to watch?
I think it's Bridgerton, but I really like also Suits and Atypical, Sex Education, like this kind of series.
Well, now let's go and talk about the World Cup in Val di Sole. It's a World Cup in your home country. Do you think that makes it extra special?
Yes, for sure. I'm really looking forward to race the World Cup in Val di Sole, first of all, because it's in Italy, and it will be special because my family and a lot of my friends are coming to cheer for me, and I think it will be really nice to do a World Cup race in front of all my people. And also, as we know, There will be a special condition with the snow, and I think it will be really special because I think no one never race a complete race on the snow.
Do you like that the race is on the snow? Do you like racing in the snow, or don't you like it?
I think I will like it. I have done a couple of races in the past on the snow, for example, the World Cup in Ungheria. I think in 2012 or 13, I actually don't remember really well, but it was completely on the snow, and I liked it, and I like the parkours and the conditions. But I think it will be a bit different than there, because, for example, there it was raining, snowing only during the night and then in the morning. But here there is already snow since I think few weeks, and I think it's going to snow again, so I think it will be different.
Last year, or actually I must say earlier this year, you also raced in Lille in Belgium. That was also a snowy race. Do you think that the races will be comparable, or is the type of snow going to be different?
Maybe in some part of the parkour where the snow was a bit higher, I think it will be comparable, but not of all the track. But I think it will be something like that. Because in Lille also, there is the ground that is sand, and maybe is a bit, in some way, I think it can be similar to the snow. But yes, I'm not sure because I never done it, so I don't know.
Of course, snow makes for a slippery race. What type of riders will benefit from this?
I think, the stronger will get the benefit, like all the other races. But I think it will be a race also for the riders who has good skills with the bike.
Lucinda Brandt, the world champion, has announced that she will not be riding Val di Sol. On the other hand, Marianne Vos will be riding Val di Sol. Do you think that Marianne Vos will be the big favorite, or will other riders be the bigger favorites?
I think Marianne will be one of the biggest favorites, with also Betsema, Anne-Marie, Sailing, Alvarado. Yes, all the stronger that arrive always in the front every week, actually.
Of course, it's also about being strong, but does the snow also have a lot to do with the technique? And maybe, is it in some way comparable with riding through sand?
I think in some way it can be comparable, but I think it's not the same. Because I think in the sand you have to let the bike go in a certain way. And you also need the power to push in the sand. But yeah, I think in the snow is a bit different. Also because maybe in some part it will be like the ground will be iced. So maybe it will be slippery, and on the top there are lines. So I actually don't know, but I think, and we will need good skills with the bike to race there.
The last World Cup you raced in Italy was Fiuggi. That parkour was super slippery as well. I think we will find a better parkour here. Do you think that, unlike Fiuggi, Val di Sol will be able to stay on the calendar in the future?
I think these are two really different parkours, one from the other. And I think I don't know exactly how it is, the parkour in Val di Sole, because I just gave a look to the map of the parkour, but I never been there. But there they already organized since few years the World Cup of mountain bike, the World Championship of mountain bike. So I think they have the place, and all the things that they need to organize a good race. And for sure, if this year they will get a good coming back from the race with the good feedbacks and good organization, I think it will be in the calendar also in the future.
Do you think that having a race in the World Cup in Italy every year will lead to more children in Italy doing cyclocross because they can see the big riders do a race in their own country?
Yeah, I think that something like that will, can help children in Italy, like the children in the USA, in France, or in all the other states that they are going to do the World Cup, and not only in Belgium. And for sure, I think the Italian people, is looking forward also to see the big talents in Val di Sole. So I guess that there will be a lot of people to come there to cheer for the race.
And how is it when you are a young rider that does cyclocross in Italy? Are there a lot of races you can do, or is it difficult?
Well, maybe it's not like in Belgium, but actually it's not that bad. Like when I was young, I was still racing every week. Every week I had a different race. And okay, maybe I had to travel a little bit with the car. But yes, something that that is okay, that it was affordable. And there were a few races that were also international. It's a pity that we never had, yes, never, no, but in the last years, we didn't have a UCI C1 race, but only C2, but I think that having a race C2 is not that bad. And this year we had few in Italy, also, for example, this weekend and the next week before the Val di Sole, we have another one. So all these things, I think, that can happen to develop cyclocross in Italy.
Do you think that the bigger World Cup will help in not only developing talent in Italy? Do you like it? Or do you think that 16 races is too much and it's still too much in Netherlands and Belgium?
On my point of view, I think that 16 races are too many. And I think that how it was since 2 years ago, it was perfect. Also because like having, 10, 9 World Cups, that which is still already a lot, I think it was okay and made the World Cup special, because, you know, you say if the winner of World Cup say, okay, I win a World Cup stage this year, it means special because you have just 9 or 10 and now you have 16, which is every weekend actually. And I think it made also not so special anymore to win a World Cup, because you just have every weekend a World Cup. And yeah, and also I think it will be more fair if there will be a maximum number of World Cup in Belgium, and because now are too many in Belgium, because we have in Belgium I think more than half of the world, 6 World Cup, and then we have 10 in the other in the other countries, and I think it's maybe too much like that. But yeah, that is only my opinion.
Well, every opinion matters, and I personally agree there's still too much in Belgium and Netherlands. 9 out of 16 are in Belgium and the Netherlands. I would love to see that change, and I hope that Val di Sole can inspire more countries to have a World Cup. Personally, I think it's good that we see this year 2 races on the calendar in France. We saw Besançon. You raced there. There were quite a lot of spectators there, right?
Yeah. There were a lot of spectators. But normally in France, I think cyclocross is quite popular. And I remember also in the past that when we raced in France, there were also a lot of spectators. So, yeah, I like this. I like that we will have another World Cup in January than in France. And I think it's nice like that. And I think maybe we have to, yes, we know, but the UCI has to make the World Cup calendar a bit more like mountain bike, that I think you don't have 2 races in the same country. So I think something like that would be bad.
Yeah, that's something we've heard more. And I mean, we can talk a very long time about the World Cup, but I think we should maybe more focus on the World Cup in Val di Sole than the calendar. I mean, we've already talked a lot about it with Erwin Verwecker, for instance. He also thought a mountain bike World Cup style would be better. I think only time will tell. Maybe in 10 years we have 16 World Cups in 13 countries or something, and then we might think differently about it. But it's still very far away, and for now it's still a lot, and that's also why Lucinda Brandt is not riding here in Val di Sole, which is a shame. But I mean, you almost said it already, like if you have 16 races at some point, you need to make choices what you can and what you can't do.
Yes, I think so. Like you can't think to do, for example, all the World Cups in December and then all the races of Christmas period, because it means you are going to do, I think, I don't know, maybe 12 races in 4 weeks. That is, I think, way too many races. So, yeah, for sure you have to make choices and to do a reasonable number of races in a year, or also to make a good plan with the trainings and the races.
About that training plan, you and also your teammates, you focused on the World Cup this year. How has that been going so far?
Yes, this year we made the decision with the team, because we saw that there were all these World Cups, and so we thought, okay, maybe we have to do all these races, and then in second view, we have the other races that we like, and also with an eye also to the races in Italy, the international races in Italy. And yes, so far it's going good, I think, but like personally, I didn't have a super good start of the season because it was long that I wasn't racing because my season on the road finished in early August. So then I didn't have the rhythm in my legs, and then it was going better. Yes, I think that with the decision that me and my teammates made with the team is a good decision. It's a good calendar what we are going to do. And yes, I'm happy about the calendar that we decided.
And now in Val di Sol, what goal do you have for yourself? Maybe a result or something else?
Yeah, for sure. I would like to be in the top 10. I would like to have a top 10 in Italy. You know, there is my family there, my friends, and I think it would be really nice.
That would be a lot better than your result in Besançon, although Besançon was the worst result of the season. But what happened there? We didn't see it on the TV or read about it, but I saw you were in a higher position before the final pass, a couple of laps.
Yeah, I had a mechanical problem, and yes, I had it just like I think 200 meters after the pit zone, so I had to run until the other pit zone, but it was way too far away. And yes, and I couldn't finish the race because I was too far in the back. And but you know, something like that sometimes happens. And so this is cyclocross. But yes, I hope that I will not have any problem like that anymore, because it's not nice, you know, when you are, that I wasn't super in the front because I also had a problem in the start, but still I was going better every lap, and then I have the mechanical. So yes, it's not nice, but yes, it happens sometimes. So I hope to have a better luck, best luck during the next races.
About the other races earlier this season, are you happy with how it's going?
Yes, with higher and lower points, but yes, it's okay. I really would like to have a good December and then January. So I think my condition is okay, but sometimes my condition is good, but sometimes, especially when there are the fastest races, when I have my typical bad start, I am really penalized. And but then like in parkours where I can push and you know, there are big gaps, then I can come back. But still, when I have a bad start, then it makes it difficult to come back in the top spots of the races.
About those starts, do you struggle with explosiveness or with warming up? Or what's the problem with your starts? Why is it that we always see you come through as a diesel together with Clara Hunsinger, usually overtaking a lot of riders?
Yeah, it's true, because we are always in the same position in the first lap, actually. And but I have to admit that she has a better legs than me right now. But yes, you know, I think that is a characteristic of my muscle for sure, because I'm not explosive since always. But then in the moment when I start to have one bad start and then another one bad start, it makes harder also with my mind to say, okay, you can do a good start again. Because if I have to look back to the first races of the season, I think the first six races I didn't have a bad start, and then it starts with one time, and then maybe the second time the other race no, and then another one, and then it's like I enter in a sort of circle, and I struggle with it. And yes, it's not nice, because you know, then if you have the aerobic capacity to do a good race, but you do a bad start, then yes, you can choose a lot of position, but it's never enough.
That's unfortunate. Do you think that the starts have become faster and faster with the younger riders? Because we always see Femme van Empel, Puk Pietersen, Sherin van Anrooy, Katablanca Vash, they have super quick starts. Do you think that the level of cyclocross has gone up the past couple of years?
Yes, I think so. I think that the new riders are really talented, and they are, I think, really explosive and reactive. But in the same times, I think the new riders are really good to ride bike. And if I am to compare the riders in the past with the new young riders, I think the younger riders can ride the bike much better than in the past. Like, if we just think about the obstacles, like in the past, almost no one was jumping the barriers. And now you see the really young riders like Hoop Peters, or I saw in Tabor one juniores that was jumping the barriers as well. So it's, I think it's, yeah, the level is going up and up and up every year.
And how is that for you to need to compete with them mentally? Because a couple of seasons ago, you were always fighting for the win, for a podium. Now you're fighting for top 10, which still is a very good result. But I can imagine that mentally, it must be difficult to adapt to such a change.
Yes, for sure it's not easy. Because like when you come from the 10th place and then you compete for the podium, it's okay. But when you have been on the top, always in the top five, always, and then you struggle to be in the top 10, you know that it starts to be like, oh, but now it's difficult. And maybe you start also to make a lot of questions about yourself, and maybe if you are not doing things in the good way, or something that is not good anymore. But I can tell that during the 2021, I made a lot of changes in my preparation and my everyday. Like I changed a coach, I changed a team, I changed my dietist and mental coach. So I made changes because maybe I was arrived in a point that to make another step in better, I had to change something. So I gave it a try, and I hope now I will see some good result of it.
So it was your own decision to leave the 777 team and go for this new adventure at Team Valcar?
Yes, it was my decision because, first of all, for me, it was starting to be really tough to live in Belgium. And I was there, and yes, the team was giving me the bikes, the camper, but for all the rest, I had to organize by myself. And for me, it was starting to be too much. Because, you know, when you are a Belgian rider or a Dutch rider and you go to the races with your family or friends that drive the camper and you go to the race, it's okay. But every time that I had to come home, coming back home and then going back to Belgium, I had to organize by myself all the trips and everything. And it was really, really stressful for me that. And then I had the opportunity to race in this team that is the twin team of Valcar, which I am also riding for the road. And I think that this decision can make, it's a good choice also for my career, because racing for 12 months in the same team, I think it makes things going better, because you don't have to sacrifice yourself 100% for the road and then 100% for the cyclocross. But, you know, if the team manager and the boss is one, you can make a better plan for racing during all the year. Like, I appreciate and I'm happy that I've done these 4 years in the past in Belgium. Because I think I learned a lot about cyclocross and also for my personal life experience, because I think that I grew a lot in the last 4 years, but I arrived in a point that it starts to be too much for me. Because, yes, I am Italian actually, and my home is in Italy. I understand that races are in Belgium, but I think that I can find a better way to make things work in the best way for me.
And do you think all these changes you made, that they worked off, maybe not only in your results, but do you feel better now?
Yes, for sure. I'm really happy that I changed team so far, because I was not feeling anymore in a good place in the last year, especially. So this year I actually find again the smile to go to the races, and because I was feeling like I was in a sort of circle that everything was like that for every week, and like I almost forgot the sense of what I was doing. And now I'm really happy with the new team, the new experience, and the new teammates. And yes, I really enjoy every week to go to the races.
Well, that's really good to hear, and we hope you can get another World Cup top 10 here in Val di Sol, because you already got one this season in Zonhoven, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, that's true. And yes, I really hope to get other top 10 spots during this other second part of the year, if you can say like that, especially in Val di Sole, because yes, it's in Italy, and I really care about that race.
Well, thank you very much for wanting to talk with us about the World Cup in Val di Sol. If you have any last words, you can still share them.
No, I just want to invite all our listeners to come to Val di Sole, of course, to cheer for, not for me, but for us, for who want to cheer. And yes, that also think, yes, the race in Val di Sole, it will be a good chance for cyclocross to maybe be introduced for the Olympic, the Winter Olympic Games. And maybe, I don't know, if we are really lucky for the Olympic Games of Milano Cortina, it will be, yes, something really, really nice for the cyclocross rider. So we have to cross our fingers for the race in Val di Sole, and then we will see.
Well, that's great news. We also hope it will come on the Olympics. Thank you very much for wanting to talk with us.
Thank you to invite me, and have a nice day.
Well, now we've heard from Eva Lechner and Alice Marie Ardzoufi, we can talk about the race a bit ourselves, and Twan is here to do that. Hello, Twan.
Hello.
We have a pretty small start list for Val di Sol. Who are missing, Twan?
Pretty much everyone from the umbrella of the Roodhoofd teams, except a few of the women that have decided to probably just show up themselves, which are Pietersen and Kant. And also the whole team of Trek isn't here. So no Lucinda Brandt, no Alvarado, no André Worst. And we're just looking at Betsema, Pietersen, Van Empel, Vos, and I think Rochette as the most interesting name on the starting line here.
Of course, also no Clara Honsinger, or, well, there's two Americans here, Alison Aronsman and Corey Kogan-Krizik. Of course, the American Championships are this week, so that makes sense that those aren't there. There's also a bunch of French riders missing, only Hélène Clausel is at the start list, because the final weekend of the Coupe de France is here. It's also the final weekend of the Czech races, so that means, of the Toy to Toy Cup, that is, so that means the Czech riders aren't here either. So it doesn't leave us with a lot, especially considering we don't see the riders of the Star Casino team here, which means no Riberol, no Honesty, etc., no Anna Kay. I think there is also, yeah, there is a double weekend in the UK, which obviously also attracted quite some riders. In my opinion, very unfortunate to see such a small start list here in Val di Sol.
Yeah, I think the planning of the Coupe de France really unfortunate as well for the French riders, because certainly some great opportunities for some of them here. I think quite a few, especially in the women's category, could have top 10 here and maybe even sneak into the top 5 or onto the podium. So yeah, it's very unfortunate that we have such a small field, even with the like second and third tier of riders.
This was inevitable, in my opinion, that it would occur at some point. I mean, most of the Roodhoofd riders are training in Spain. We see the 777 team is hosting a training camp there. And it was bound to happen at some point that there were just too many races. Like, this is the final weekend of big, big, big international races. I just mentioned the races. A lot of national series are coming to a closing point just before the Christmas period, when the attention really fully shifts toward Belgium. Then we will see massive start lists, just like we saw at the previous round or of the Super Prestige that was in Boom. So yeah, it was inevitable. However, there are some riders here. One of the most prominent names is Marianne Vos, who is restarting her cyclocross season after a break. Do you think that Vos is immediately the big favorite here, or should we look at someone else, Tom?
I think for the favorites, she has to be up there. I think it's the five names, and probably Van Empel is the weakest one out of the five. It's going to be a very interesting race. Rochette looking really strong the past few weeks as well. It will be interesting to see what she can do for a challenge to victory.
I think we're going to see an interesting race here. Purely based on reputation, I would expect Betsema to be the best. But Betsema was, I don't know, she was not good last year in the Snowcross and Lille. Of course, you can't base yourself upon one race. But the snow should benefit Marianne Vos. But the question there is, which Marianne Vos are we going to see? Are we going to see the Marianne Vos of the beginning of the season, where she was in peak condition and could fight for the win and actually took the win? Or are we going to see more the Marianne Vos that we saw last year in the cyclocross season, which we were expecting at the beginning of the season in our preseason podcast, where we vastly underestimated Marianne Vos? If we see that Marianne Vos, then she, in my opinion, will be in the top 10, but only because the start field here isn't great. If we see the same Marianne Vos as earlier this year, she's immediately going to be fighting for the win. I don't expect to see that Marianne Vos. I expect that Marianne Vos will need a couple of races to really get into form. But I do expect that once we come to the World Championships, we'll see a much stronger Marianne Vos. Will she be able to win here? Not really. I don't think so. Although I will happily be surprised. I think Puk Pieterse is definitely a shot here. Snow is slippery. Puk Pieterse, in absence of Alvarado, has the best technique here. What do you think?
Yeah, as I said, it's just four women who I all see the upside of, and on their day can all win this race, which should make for a really interesting one. Or someone is just on a great day and it becomes really boring after two laps or something like that.
If we look behind that, we see two mountain bike riders that are participating, Anne Tauber and Anne Terpstra. What do you expect from these riders, Tom?
I would say, based on the starting field, actually, probably at least one of them goes into the top 10, because the field really isn't that strong at all. Last year, we saw some very promising things, I think, by Anne Tauber. I remember a 9th place in Heusden-Zolder. Which, like, it was really promising. She even managed to make the World Cup squad and the World Championship squads toward the end of the season. So it clearly shows that the national team coach also believes in her. And, Anne Terpstra has already done some racing this year. It wasn't too amazing, but she should be doing well, I think, too. Probably going to be finishing maybe nearer 15th place.
I definitely expect Tauber to be the better of the two. But if I look at the results of Anne Terpstra, yes, this season it wasn't great. Third place in a Toy 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 Cup and a 10th place in GP Destil. But if I look at previous seasons, the 2019 race in Hamme, Flandrien Cross, she ended 15th there. There she ended 2nd in a Toy 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 Cup. Also a couple of other top 10s in smaller races. She has ended 9th in the DVV Trophy of Baal in 2017, from the top of my head, around Mount Kapteins. And I think that race was won by Marianne Vos, but that's what I dig really deep for that. But she has gotten top 10s, potentially even in Overijse. But that's very vague in my memory. But if she can pick up her results again, then, or basically, I think it just depends on form. I think that she took a rest and those first cyclocross races weren't a great indication. We could see something better now. But there's also a strong bunch of Italians. I mean, we already spoke with Eva Lechner and Alice Marie Arzufi. Both are hoping for a top 10. With this start list, definitely possible in my opinion.
Last Sunday we had a race in Italy as well, where Eva Lechner took the win ahead of Art Sufi. Persico riding a really strong race, but having mechanical difficulty. Both women on the podcast, I believe, spoke about her as well. So certainly on some good form and someone to watch out for as well for potentially an outside shot at top five.
Yeah, I definitely think so. I think we'll have a pretty unpredictable race in the snow. It's easy to make mistakes. And I think experience is an important factor then. And we saw it last year in Lille. Sonnekamp could have taken the win there if it wasn't for a puncture, or at least gotten a podium. She ended fourth now, which was a shame to see there, because based on that race, she did deserve a podium there. I think this year, Sonnekamp has been average. She should end in the top 10 here. I think she still can do that. But it's just like, after Sonnekamp, like on our start list, there's not much left. I do think Kant has a shot at the top 10, but with that, everything is said. I do expect Kant to lack in terms of quality to fight for a podium here. As said, we are looking more towards the Dutch riders and Rochette. Rochette, last name here, Tom, that we need to discuss, potentially Hélène Clausel. What do you think of these two French-speaking riders?
I think, as I said, Rochette just having a very good part of the season at the moment, so it will be very interesting to see how she will challenge the Dutch women. I think a victory for her isn't out of the question at all, so it should be very interesting to see what she can do. And I think Hélène Clausel, hopefully finding some of that form that she had earlier in the season, maybe could battle for an outside shot at like fifth place-ish, that kind of area.
I definitely think so as well. Although for Clausel, it's a bit up and down this season, so hard to make a prediction on that one. But any predictions for the podium?
For the podium, I would go with a win for Marlee Rochette, second place for Denise Betsma, and third for Marianne Vos.
Nah, no way. I was going to go with that podium, but I'll go with something else then. I will go with a surprise win here for the young star Puk Pietersen. It's long overdue in my opinion that she grabs a win. And then a second place here for Marianne Vos ahead of a third place, which then goes to Femme van Empel. She's been very strong the last couple of weeks. Let's look at our men's race then, Twan. There's also a bunch of riders skipping there. Who are the main guys that are not at the start?
The guys not at the start, it would be the riders from Trek. Aerts and Van der Haar aren't here, as well as Lauren Zweek.
And then here as well, of course, a couple of riders from the second row not coming here. Cameron Mason is racing in the UK. Orts is racing in Spain. We see that there are also no Dutch second row riders. Corné van Kessel, the only Dutch rider here. All the French riders are racing in France except Anthony Hubi. But Joshua Dubow is not here. He's gotten the top 10 this season as well. So these are some of the names not here. However, Wout van Aert and Tom Pidcock are here. Wout van Aert again. Strong showing, easy win for him, or isn't it that easy?
It's hard to say because we don't see them race too much in the snow, of course, so we don't have too much comparison. But from what he showed in Boma, I would say that he should be the main favorite, of course, and I would think he's starting quite far up the rankings as well, or on the grid. So you won't have too much trouble. He'll be able to ride his own race. And I think Izerbeet, Hermans, Pidcock, they will be trying to challenge him for as long as they can. But they'll probably have to let him go at some point.
I think so as well. Wout van Aert definitely has the most power in the snow here. By what I've seen from it, power will play a big role. I think that it's a combination of power and technique. The snow doesn't look that loose unless there's some more fresh snowfall. So yeah, it's a bit of a guess how the level will be, but based on Wout van Aert's performance previous week, I expect him to be good. The other big name, of course, here is Tom Pidcock, Olympic champion mountain bike. Personally, I think that he will be in the top 10 again, but I don't expect wonders from him. It's not a perfect parcours for him, and he's been he's coming straight here from a training camp with the Ineos Grenadiers on Mallorca. So, yeah, I think Pidcock will be a bit tired. Don't expect a lot from him personally.
I think Pidcock should be with some of the guys that we have seen throughout the most of the like season before he joined. He should be hopefully battling for a top 5 position still, and hopefully keep the race interesting as long as he possibly can.
Other names we are obviously looking at here are Elise Beat and Quinten Hermans. I think it's a shame Laurens Sweek doesn't come because he prefers the Etias course in Essen. Val d'Isère is too far away for him. First of all, I think this is a wrong attitude, and second of all, he's wasting a chance at the podium, and he doesn't score a lot of podiums this season. He is a good rider in snowy races. We saw it in Lille last year, and now he skips this. Personally, I do not understand why, because in Essen, in my opinion, he will be beaten by Wout van Aert. So, yeah, I don't really understand his decision. It probably has to do with just personal preference of staying in at home, sleeping in his own bed, spending time with his family, which of course also is important, but I feel like it's the wrong mindset to have as a athlete. But nevertheless, he is not here, so we have to deal with that. I do think that Elise Beat and Quinten Hermans, potentially Michael van Turenhout as well, are names that will be fighting with Pidcock for places 2, 3, 4 and 5. What do you think out of these riders, Isabit, Hermans, van Turenhout, who will be the riders on the podium?
I think it's quite hard. I would go with like the victory for Wout van Aert probably. And then Isabit in second and Hermans in third.
What do you think then? What will make the difference for Isabit? Is it that he will improve a bit compared to last week, or is it that the snow will suit him, or what do you think is the reason that Isabit will have a strong showing?
I think Isabit just like gets the technical aspect more sometimes than some of the other guys, and I think that that's really important with the snow, especially with not that much time to adapt, of course, because you don't really race a lot over the surface.
Yeah, last Belgian I would like to mention is Tom Meuse. He's been having a decent season. I think he can definitely score a top 10 here because he likes racing in the snow. So yeah, that should be something for him as well. He's won quite a lot of races in the snow. It used to be the traditional thing to say he has never lost a cross in the snow, but that isn't true anymore. After Lille and before that, there was already something that was being disputed. However, further down the start list, I think Durigoni and Bertolini are interesting names to keep an eye on during the race. Hope these riders can get a top 10. And then a last one here, Ben Turner, Twan. What do you expect from him?
Yeah, it's really good to see him on the start list, racing together with Pidcock as they both entered the field for Boom. Got off to a really good start, and well, this is his opportunity to get a top 10. The starting field just not as strong as you'd like it to be, so plenty of opportunities. Let's see if he can actually take them.
You already made your prediction for the podium. Now I can go with mine. I will be copying your first place of Wout van Aert taking the win. I think that we will see a second place for Elisabeth, but then a third place for Corne van Kessel, who's been pretty good the last couple of weeks. Well, Twan, we've covered it here. Thank you for joining me.
Thanks for having me on.
And of course, we still thank Eva Lechner and Alice Marie Arzufi for joining us as well. This weekend, first on Saturday, the Etias course in Essen, and then on Sunday, we have the World Cup in Val d'Isère. Thank you guys for listening. Goodbye.